कुछ एग्जांपल भी हैं, देर आर सम प्रॉब्लम्स हियर. फर्स्ट दी अलजेब्रा ऑफ सबस्पेसेस. थ्योरम वन, द इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ एनी टू सबस्पेसेस W1 एंड W2 ऑफ वेक्टर स्पेस VF इज आल्सो ए सबस्पेस ऑफ VF. इट मींस वी हैव टू सबस्पेसेस W1 एंड W2, टेक देयर इंटरसेक्शन. द थ्योरम सेज दैट विल आल्सो बी ए सबस्पेस. सी इट्स प्रूफ. Since this zero vector belongs to W1 and zero vector belongs to W2. Why? Because W and W2 both are subspaces. Therefore, their intersection will also contain this vector W, this zero vector, and so W intersection W2 is not empty. Suppose alpha beta belongs to W1 intersection W2 and A and B belongs to F. So alpha will be in W1 intersection W2. It implies alpha is in W1 and alpha is in W2. Similarly, beta is belonging to W1 intersection W2, implies that beta belongs to W1 and beta belongs to W2. Since this intersection, that is why here word AND is used. Since W1 is a subspace, therefore AB belongs to F and alpha beta belongs to W1, it implies that A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1. Since W1 is a subspace, similarly, AB belongs to F and alpha beta belongs to W. It implies A alpha plus B beta belongs to W2, since W2 is also a subspace. Now from these two, A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1 and A alpha plus B beta belongs to W2. It implies that A alpha plus B beta belongs to in their intersection, means W1 intersection W2. Thus, AB belongs to F and alpha beta belongs to W1 intersection W2. It implies that A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1 intersection W2. Hence, W1 intersection W2 is a subspace of VF. Earlier, we have studied about this theorem that for AB in F and alpha beta in V, A alpha plus B beta belongs to W, then W will be a vector subspace. Now, see here, note the union of two subspaces of VF may not be a subspace. But the intersection of two subspaces is a vector subspace. But in case of union, it is not true. For example, suppose R be the field of real numbers and we have two vector spaces W1, 0, 0, Z, Z belongs to R, and W2, 0, Y, 0, such that Y belongs to R. Then 0, 0, 3 will be in W1 and 0, 5, 0 will be in W2, but their sum 0, 0, 3 plus 0, 5, 0 is equal to 0, 5, 3. It is not in W1 union W2, whereas 0, 0, 3 and 0, 5, 0, they will both belong to their union, W1 union, W2. But this is not in their union. The sum is not in their union because neither 053 belongs to W1 nor it belongs to 053 belongs to W2. None of the W1 W2 contains this 053. Thus, W1 union W2 is not closed under vector addition. Hence, this is not a subspace of V3R. See another theorem. The union of two subspaces is a subspace if and only if one is contained in the other. Here we have two subspaces W and W2, but their union is not a subspace. But here there is a condition. If we have two subspaces, then their union will be a subspace if and only if one is contained in the other. See its proof. Suppose W and W2, they are two subspaces of a vector space V. And suppose W1 is in contained in W2 or W2 is in contained in W1, then W1 union W2 will be W2 or W1. Since one is contained in another, so either it will be equal to W1 or it will be equal to W2. But W1 and W2 both are subspaces and therefore their union will also be a subspace, no doubt, because union will be either W1 or W2, which is a subspace. Conversely, suppose it is a subspace, W1 union W2 is a subspace. Now our target is we need to prove that W1 is in W2 or W2 is in W1. So let us assume that W1 is not a subset of W2. Suppose this is not true and W2 is also not a subset of W1 and this is also not true. Now, since W1 is not a subset of W2, it implies that there exists some alpha in W1 which is not in W2. Okay, since W1 is not a subset of W2, it means W1 contains at least one element alpha which is not in W2. Similarly, suppose since W2 is not a subset of W1, it implies that there exists beta in W2 such that beta is not in W1. It is also true since W2 is not a subset of W1, so W2 will contain at least one element which is not in W1. Then from 1 and 2, we get alpha belongs to W1 union W2. Since alpha is in W1, so it will be in their union, and beta is in W2, so beta will also be in their union, since union means either in W1 or in W2 or in both. Now, since W1 union W2 is a subspace, it is our assumption. Therefore, alpha plus beta is also in W1 union W2. No doubt, since it is subspace, it will be close under vector addition, and alpha and beta both are in this. But alpha plus beta belongs to W1 union W2. It implies that alpha plus beta belongs to W1 or in W2, according to the definition of union of two sets. Suppose alpha plus beta belongs to W1. Since alpha belongs to W1 and W1 is a subspace, then alpha plus beta minus alpha will be beta, and it will also be in W1. Since W1 is a subspace, therefore this relation the result of this relation will be in W1, and it is beta, so it will be in W1, but it contradicts our this 2. But from 2 we have beta is not in W1, thus we get a contradiction. Again, suppose alpha plus beta belongs to W2. Since beta belongs to W2 and W2 is a subspace, therefore alpha plus beta minus beta, it is equal to alpha, is in W2. But this contradicts our statement 1. Thus, here also we get a contradiction, hence either W1 is in W2 or W2 is in W1. So the theorem is proved that the two union of two subspaces is a subspace if and only if one is contained in the other. Now see, there is another theorem for your algebra of subspaces. See here, theorem 3, arbitrary intersection of subspaces. It means the intersection of any family of subspaces of vector space is a subspace. We have a vector space and we have several subspaces of this vector space. Take its intersection, either take two vector subspaces or take three subspaces or take more than subspaces and take their intersection. So arbitrary intersection of subspaces, that is the intersection of any family of subspaces will be a subspace. See its proof. Suppose VF is a vector space and let W2 be any family of subspaces where T belongs to capital T. This T is in an index set. This T can be set of natural numbers, set of integers, or set of rationals, anything. But our aim is to show that this W2 may be W1, W2, W3, and so on. So this is a family of subspaces. It may have W1, W2, or W1, W3, or W2, W3, or W5, W7, etc. Here this T is an index set, and it is such that for all T in capital T, WT is a subspace of E. It means for every small t in this capital T, whatever we choose this capital T, this W small t will be a vector subspace of V. Next, let U is denoted by intersection of WT where T belongs to capital T. Means there are some vector spaces whose intersection is denoted by capital U. So it will be contain all the elements x in V, all those x in V such that x belongs to WT for all T in capital T. So be the intersection of this family of subspaces of V. Then we need to prove that U is also a subspace of V. Since we need to prove what? Any family of subspaces is a vector space. So this is our family of subspace. So it should be proved as it is a vector subspace. It is clear that U is not equal to phi, cannot be, since at least the zero vector of V is in WT. Since this its definition says that X in V such that X belongs to WT, at least this V contains zero vector. Since this contains zero vector, so this intersection will contain zero vector, so it cannot be equal to phi. Next, let AB belongs to F and alpha beta be any two elements of intersection WT, T belongs to capital T. then alpha belong, beta belongs to WT for all T. Since WT is a subspace of V, therefore A alpha plus beta belongs to WT for all T. Therefore, A alpha plus beta belongs to intersection WT for all T. It proves. It is our earlier theorem that W for a vector space V, we have a set non-empty subset W. Then W will be a subspace of V if A, B belongs to F and alpha beta belongs to W, implies that A alpha plus B beta belongs to W. This is our theorem. So according to that theorem, this intersection of family of subspaces is a vector subspace. Thus, AB belongs to F and alpha belongs to intersection WT. It implies that A alpha plus beta belongs to intersection WT. Hence, intersection WT is a subspace of VF. See two more definition very fast. We can do it. A smallest subspace containing any subset of VF. Suppose V be a vector space and S be any subset of V. If U is a subspace of V containing S, U is a subspace of V containing S, and it is itself contained in every subspace of V containing S. So U will be the smallest subspace of V containing S. So clear. We have the vector space V has several subspaces, and U is a subspace which contains S. Then, and this U is contained in all subspaces of V. So U will be the smallest subspace of V, and this smallest subspace of V containing S, we also call it the subspace of V generated or spanned by S. And we shall denote it by the symbol S in inverted brackets, curly brackets. It can be easily shown that the intersection of all the subspaces of VF containing S is a subspace of VF generated by S. If S is equal to V, then we say that V is spanned by S. So S is contained in U, which is a subset of V. And U is the smallest subspace containing S. After that, in the next class, we will study about linear combination of vectors, linear span, and linear dependence, independence, etc. But for now, our